Hello and welcome to this lesson on sensory motor stage of cognitive development as given by Jean Piaget. This lesson is focused on the first stage of development or the sensory motor stage of development. We'll be taking up each of the sub stages within this stage in great detail. According to Piaget, the first 2 years of a child's life are so intense that it involves vast leaps in cognitive development. And that is the reason sensory motor stage has a lot of work to be done by the child. Hence, it is divided into 6 sub-stages. We'll take each of these sub-stages in little detail as we go further. But before we go further, let us just understand what sensory motor stage is all about. Sensory motor stage is the stage when the infant is responding to the environment only through the sensory and motor equipment which is there with the infant. So the infant is basically responding to the environmental stimulation through his or her senses and through its motor or muscular actions. That is why the name sensory motor stage. Coming to the substages in detail, the first stage or the reflexive scheme starts at the time of birth and continues for 1 month. In this substage, the child's behaviors or responses to environmental stimulation are basically in the form of reflexes. We know that infants are by birth gifted with several reflexes which help them relate to their world. Rooting and palmar grasp are examples of such reflexes. Rooting, as we know, is the behavior of turning the head and opening the mouth when touched on the cheek. And palmar grasp happens when a finger or some other object is pressed against the baby's palm, the baby's fingers close around it. So the baby's responses to environmental stimulation are basically in the form of such reflexes. The baby indiscriminately applies these reflexes to environmental stimulation. In other words, the baby is not able to discriminate between stimuli. The baby is just responding to the environmental stimulation through whatever is given to the baby, which is nothing but reflexes at this stage. Another feature of this stage is sensory motor egocentrism. Sensory motor egocentrism refers to the fact that the infant is not able to differentiate between his own self and the world. So there is no differentiation between, no separation between the self of the child and the world. The second substage or the stage of primary circular reactions is a stage when the baby has gained control over their activities by repeating chance behaviors. So the baby now has greater control over motor actions. But these actions are circular reactions. Why? Because they are repeated by the child over and over again. And they are primary because they originate from the baby's body and are guided by the baby's primary needs. A good example of primary circular reactions is sucking of the thumb or fist to seek pleasure. So the baby now has control over certain motor actions which he or she can repeat for pleasure. Coming to the third substage or the secondary circular reactions, this stage starts from 4 months and goes till 8 months. This is the time when the child is able to sit up and he or she becomes more skilled at grasping and manipulating objects. This stage again involves circular reactions. That means the baby's motor movements are again circular or repetitive in nature, but they are secondary because the baby tries to repeat interesting sounds and sights which are caused by their own actions. To clarify this further, let us take an example. Let us say that the baby has a toy, a 4 to 8 month old baby has a toy which has keys which when pressed produces music. Now the child at this stage is able to pat the toy again and again in a repetitive motion but is not able to explore the toy for what it is. So these circular movements of patting the toy to create interesting sound is something which has a circular nature for the child. But the child has not yet developed the ability to explore the toy for what it is. The child is in a way caught up with his or her own secondary circular reaction of patting the toy and by chance pressing the key over and over again. An important development which takes place at this stage is that the baby's attention is now guided towards outward environment. Earlier, in the primary circular reaction stage, the baby's motor activities or circular reactions were primarily guided by the baby's own primary needs and were centered towards the body. Whereas here, the circular reactions are more towards the external environment. Before we try and understand the fourth stage, that is the coordination of secondary circular reactions, let us take an example. Let us take the example of Piaget's object hiding tasks, in which he shows the baby an attractive toy and then hides it behind his hand or under a cover. Now, infants of this substage can find the object. They are able to find the object by performing two secondary circular reactions. One, by pushing aside the obstacle, and two, by grasping the toy. So these are the two secondary circular reactions which the infant is able to coordinate to solve a problem at hand. This is precisely what we mean by coordination of secondary circular reactions, which happens during the fourth substage around 8 months to 12 months of age. Because the infants are able to combine their secondary circular reactions, they are able to solve some problems for themselves. For example, finding a toy, a hidden toy. That is how they are able to engage in intentional or goal-directed behavior. So they can break the problem into sub-problems. For instance, in this case, the child was able to break the problem into one, removing the obstacle, and two, grasping the toy. So they can break their problems into sub-problems and engage in goal-directed behavior. At this stage, the infants are also able to achieve object permanence. Object permanence refers to the understanding that objects continue to exist when they are out of sight. Piaget, through his object hiding tasks, was able to demonstrate that babies at this age do have object permanence. That is, when things are not in their sight, they still have a mental memory of those things. That is why the child, when the toy is hidden from the child goes and tries to retrieve it. However, through his experiments, Piaget concluded that object permanence starts at this age but is not complete yet. It develops as the child grows further cognitively. Coming to stage 5, or the tertiary circular reactions, these circular reactions now become tertiary because the child is able to use them experimentally and creatively. Now, let us again take up another example. Suppose a child who learns to drop things now is dropping things down the basement stairs, down the balcony, or down the window. In this manner, the child is able to use the circular reaction of dropping, or the dropping scheme, in multiple ways, in experimental ways, and in creative ways. So this is what is an accomplishment during this stage. The child is able to repeat the circular reactions in a more experimental and creative way, along with a lot of variation. Also, at this stage, object permanence improves, or the ability or the understanding that objects, if they are out of sight, still exist, improves. Coming to the last stage, or the mental representation stage, here, infants are able to form mental representation or internal images of absent objects and past events. And because of these internal events, now the problem-solving behavior of infants changes from trial and error method to thinking in the head. So earlier, the baby was trying out various circular reactions to solve problems. Now the baby is able to think mentally and solve problems in the head, followed by application of that solution behaviorally. Another important achievement during this stage is deferred imitation, or the ability to remember and copy the behavior of models who are not immediately present. So since the infant is able to form mental representations or internal images of objects, events, and people, the infant has greater ability to imitate models who are not immediately present in the surrounding. Towards the end of this stage, there is another accomplishment which is called the make-believe play, in which children enact familiar activities such as pretending to eat, go to sleep, or drive a car. Make-believe play is possible because of the infant's capacity for mental representation or internal images of absent objects and past events. By the time the last substage, or the mental representation stage, starts, the infant is already about to be 2 years. By the time the infant is 2 years, infant has completed the sensory motor stage of cognitive development, and he or she then moves to the next stage of cognitive development, which is the pre-operational stage. In our next lecture, we are going to learn about this next stage, or the pre-operational stage of cognitive development. That's all for today's lecture. Enjoy watching this lecture till we meet again tomorrow. But before we leave, let us go to our overview slide and take stock of what all we have done and what we need to cover. So 3 lectures we had covered earlier, the fourth one we covered today. The fourth one is the sensory motor stage of cognitive development during infancy. Next, we'll be doing the pre-operational and concrete operational stage. Keep learning, be happy, thank you.